Hi everyone, my name is Verena Dittrich. I'm the CEO, one of the founders of RedWave Medical. After my very short introduction yesterday, for those who watched it, today I want to introduce you to the future of blood pressure measurement with much more details and background information. So the big picture, how will the future of blood pressure measurement look like? Imagine you wake up in the morning, go to the bathroom, and your mirror will give you already the current overview on your heart and artery health status. Basically, a full assessment of your cardiovascular health in that very moment. During the day or night, you could continue measuring if you wish to or if you have to, with different applications and devices. And in your doctor's office, you can get additional checkups on the spot or over 24 hours. The results of all those different measurements fit well together and provide the medical accuracy needed for diagnosis and therapy for several cardiovascular health issues. If we look at blood pressure measurement today, we are far from that picture. The cuff technology, which is widespread in doctors' practices and hospitals, works very good and is clinically valid. But many people see their doctor only once per year. For home applications, there are also cuffs available. But they are only used by people who already know that they have hypertension. Lately, some wearables and smartwatches entered the market, but mostly their assessment results are not comparable to those cuff readings in the doctor's office or even lack medical accuracy. So let's have a closer look on what are the problems in creating the next generation of blood pressure measurement. First, blood pressure itself is an aggregate parameter. In the past, the measurement of brachial blood pressure was considered representative for cardiovascular health. But as in every aggregate, we lose a lot of information. What I'm saying is that the most frequently performed medical examination in the world, blood pressure measurement, is still not used to get all the parameters and get them all precisely enough for the diagnosis, individual therapy, and therapy monitoring. For example, if we have a look at the invasive pressure curves, that's the gold standard, by the way. Per definition, the highest peak of every pulse wave is the systolic blood pressure, and the lowest one is the diastolic pressure. Every information in between is not assessed right now. Second, cuffless measurement still fails for many diseases. Measurement is technically actually not a pressure measurement, so we have to rely on other inputs and use algorithms. In the best, these inputs are physiological signals directly linked by cause and effect to what we want. So is the pulse wave, which is directly linked to the heart and artery function. But several algorithm solutions for cuffless applications, which we saw so far, use so-called surrogate values like age or heart rate. Using surrogates means that the solutions work well for healthy people, like for fitness tracking, but for the medical diagnosis, they need to function exactly the other way around. Easy example, they need to identify those young people who have hypertension, and in the same way, they need to find those old people who have normal blood pressure, independent from age. And in the best case, we can even see why the pressure readings are as they are. The third problem is linked to the second one, a lack of acceptance of cuff measurement systems among professionals, which is due either to limited or yet unproven medical accuracy and clinical validity. Now let's look at the solutions for all three problems. As I said, in the past, brachial blood pressure was considered representative for cardiovascular health, but it is an aggregate parameter. The solution is to use pulse wave analysis to unhide the details of cardiovascular health. For example, we can see what amount of blood pressure is caused by heart function and if there is an abnormal pressure increase by arterial function. Therefore, we can use a range of parameters like pulse wave velocity, brachial blood pressure, central blood pressure, cardiac output, blood variability, just to name a few. Basically, we can benefit from pulse wave analysis because it provides a detailed assessment of cardiovascular risk due to the determination of heart function, vascular function, and artery age. This information is far more than just blood pressure. Therefore, pulse wave analysis enables an earlier, faster, and more individual response, either by lifestyle changes or by medication. Additionally, we can and should use pulse wave analysis to monitor two things. One, the slow and long-term changes of the arterial system, which might manifest in hypertension. And two, track the short-term changes or regulation effects caused by activity or stress. For example, in blood pressure, everybody has like a baseline or a resting blood pressure and a range of natural variability for short-term or even micro changes. But that baseline can elevate over time, so hypertension develops. The second solution is to enable cuffless measurement for healthy and disease cases. We can do that by basing pulse wave analysis purely on the relevant physiological signals, which are directly linked by cause and effect to what we want to measure, basically the pulse waves. Thereby, we have to avoid surrogate parameters, especially patient age. In the midterm, the aim is, of course, to become calibration-free, and here it is even more important to avoid the influence of surrogates. The third solution is to increase the acceptance of cuffless measurement among professionals, mostly by providing medical accuracy and clinical validity. Well, where are we now? There are several validated methods for blood pressure measurement and pulse wave analysis, with the invasive method considered gold standard because it is a direct measurement of pressure changes. There we can directly record the pulse waves and see the differences in shape and in pressure between the aorta and also the other arteries. Now, after a lot of background information, how does red wave shape the future of cardiovascular health? We provide modular algorithms for the assessment of key health issues like blood pressure, vascular aging, heart failure, and hemodynamics. They all can be used in different devices and different intentions, such as spot measurement, 24 hours measurements, or continuous measurements. Our algorithms can handle a variety of signals, invasive or oscillometric or PPG signals. However, our core competence is signal processing, so the part in the middle. And then we provide the desired output parameters as software modules for your devices. Basically, we customize it, we integrate it, you run it, done. That's how we enable your medical devices for the future of blood pressure measurement. To illustrate what I just said before, I now want to introduce you on how you can be a medical pioneer with our Antares algorithm for oscillometric blood pressure monitors. Antares uses a unique and patented approach in pulse wave analysis by processing deflation or inflation cuff data, so it can be implemented in any upper arm cuff device. Currently, two modules are the central blood pressure and pulse wave velocity, which can be used for early detection and therapy support of high blood pressure and early vascular aging. Antares is validated against the invasive gold standard in a multicentric study. We enable your devices by easy implementation through minimum requirements on the device and on the signal. Also, we are 13485 certified as a medical supplier, so we provide the technical documentation for the CE approval of your devices. Finally, some information on RedWave as a company. RedWave was founded in 2017 by four people, and each of us had a work history in the field of pulse wave analysis for about 10 years or even more. RedWave is located in Jena. We are eight people in the team. To sum up what we do, medical-grade algorithms for early detection, prevention, and therapy monitoring of cardiovascular diseases with highest medical accuracy and valid results. Our algorithms are available as B2B software licenses for blood pressure equipment manufacturers, sensor manufacturers, or medical device manufacturers. Our algorithms are modular, so you can basically pick the piece that you want to implement and integrate it into your devices easily. Our vision is that everyone can have the opportunity to be fully and, most important, accurately informed about the state of their cardiovascular system anytime. That's how RedWave will shape the future of blood pressure measurement. If you want to have more information on us, please visit our website or contact me or my colleagues on the trade show right now. Thanks a lot.